56-year-old Sandra Henderson, mother of two and grandmother four times over, wants another baby.
You don't want to say it out loud, just in case.
Oh, this time next month I could be pregnant, you know. This time next month I could actually be pregnant.
Because of her age, the only way she can become pregnant is by having expensive and controversial fertility treatment.
They want you to take that commitment on. It was their last hope.
But there's a lot at stake. Having a baby at her age will push her body to the limit.
Oh, I don't want it.
Turn her family against her.
That's dreadful, dreadfully selfish.
People her age just don't do those things.
And take her relationship to breaking point.
Don't understand.
At 56, Sandra faces an uphill struggle to get the baby she so badly wants. But will the price she has to pay to become one of Britain's oldest mums be worth it? Sandra lives in Byfleet, a village in Surrey. She lives alone after her first marriage ended in divorce 10 years ago.
I have two children and I have four grandchildren. So, it's quite good, isn't it?
So this is Lisa and Glenn. That's my daughter and my son. Gosh almighty, Lisa's going to be 34 this year and Glenn's 30. Luke, that's Lisa's eldest son, and his fishing rod, which my son's a fisherman, so they go fishing together. This is me with Rihanna and Bryony and Luke.
How do you think your grandchildren would feel if you had a child that was younger than them?
Funny, isn't it? I don't know. Never even thought about it. You know, they'd probably just say it's another baby in the family and that's it, accept it as that.
Sandra's fiancé, Michael, lives 60 miles away. They met 5 years ago at the spiritualist church they both attend. At 47, he's never been married and has no children.
I didn't want to go through my life feeling, you know, that I would lose out on the emotion of bringing a child into the world.
Sandra's too old to have a baby naturally, so her only hope is expensive IVF treatment. Just a handful of women of her age have ever attempted it, and the odds are stacked against her. The family are against her plans too. Daughter Lisa is horrified.
I think it's extremely selfish to have a child. No matter how much you want a child, you have to be able to make some sort of reassurance that you can see it full grown and that it won't end up nursing you.
Despite the high cost, the odds, and the total opposition of the family, Michael and Sandra are determined to go ahead.
It's because you're with the person that you want to be with, and I think it's natural. You get married and you have children and you live happily ever after. You don't stop feeling the same way just because you get older. You know, you just, okay, you've got a relationship that you want to not only develop between the two of you, but you actually want to develop in every sense. You know, and especially as Michael hasn't had children.
Because of her age, Sandra was turned down by every fertility clinic in the country. The only doctor who has agreed to treat her is Professor Ian Craft, a specialist pioneering IVF for the growing number of older women wanting a baby.
Women are discriminated against already enough in this country, those who are infertile. And the NHS may treat you up to the age of 35, but you go to 37, you've had it. And we've made a decision to treat patients between 50 and 56. Other centres haven't done that. My reasoning is that women do have children between 50 and 56 naturally.
I can see, you know, what other people think of when they look at me and look at Michael and what the hell are we doing? It's bloody stupid. And what this poor child is going to go through. And you've just got to go what you believe is right. And Michael and I believe this is right.
Sandra and Michael arrive at the London Fertility Clinic for the IVF treatment. Their timing's perfect. It's Mother's Day.
This has got to be, of this day, above all days, actually, the day when everything works, if you like, and really, mum's the word.
Yeah.
Sandra's IVF treatment depends on eggs donated by a younger woman. These were put in a dish with Michael's sperm. They fertilized and 7 embryos formed. The 2 most developed embryos have been selected and prepared for the transplant into Sandra's womb. The rest are frozen.
There's no guarantee of a baby occurring, and it would be so nice to make one on Mother's Day, wouldn't it?
This is panic time.
This is the moment Sandra and Michael have been waiting for.
Don't be apprehensive, because there's nothing to worry about. When I first started doing this about 20 or 25 years ago, because our first children, what, 20 years, we didn't, people used to lie still in bed for a day, didn't dare cross their legs.
That's me, that's what I'm wondering.
Oh, no, no, none of that. You just behave quite normally. Now you're here for 10 minutes and off you go and behave quite normally, Lucy. Thank you. See, I told you she wouldn't take long. And they're in this little, the embryos are in this little tiny tube here. Hmm? So we're now going to position that to hopefully watch it go to where I want to be. Now here it comes up. Watch it coming up there, look at that. There it goes, up, up.
Helped by heavy doses of hormone tablets, Sandra will have the same chance of success as any other woman having IVF, around 1 in 3.
Fabulous. In go the embryos, watch, there they go. Beautiful. Lovely position.
They've reached their destination.
They're in the right place, I can assure you, but whether they're going to do their job is yet to be seen. The question of how anybody might become pregnant depends on 3 different things, really. One is the quality of embryos that you generate, one is the environment, and one is fate to a large extent, too.
That was pretty amazing, wasn't it? Yeah.
Speechless.
Come on. I know. Okay, we just got to pray a lot now. Don't start me off.
Sandra and Michael will have to wait 2 weeks to find out if their dream of having a baby will come true. With young children of her own to look after, Lisa's reservations are deepening.
Even at my age, I feel it. Their children are hard to keep up with and they have so much energy. By the time you've reached a few more years down the line, it must be more hard work. And with a toddler running off into the distance, you have to be able to keep up with it. If it's climbing trees, you have to be able to go up after it. And if it falls in a river, you have to be able to go in after it. You have to have all your faculties and all your abilities. And okay, Mum does at the moment, but there's no guarantee for the future.
I don't feel old, neither does Sandra. Anybody is as old or as young as they actually feel. We feel perfectly capable of being responsible parents and to give a child a good upbringing. And for that, we're bringing life into the world, and this child is the most wanted child we could possibly want.
After 2 long weeks of waiting, Sandra and Michael return to the clinic to find out if Sandra's pregnant.
I think good blood, you know.
Bang, done.
One more hour and they'll find out the results.
A lovely 40 minutes.
The Patients offer themselves up to a fertility centre and say, please make me pregnant. But you can only do what you're unable to do. You can only do it to your best ability. You can't necessarily change the science.
You actually feel as though it's what you've done wrong, you know. You just think, well, you know, you gave it your best shot, absolute best shot, and it's a no. So if your best shot's, you know, not good enough, maybe the second shot isn't going to be anything like it, you know, and you're just setting yourself up for an even bigger fall, you know?
Sandra and Michael now face a difficult decision. They've used up the two best embryos, but there are still five left, frozen at minus 180 degrees. Thawed out, these would give Sandra and Michael a second chance. But frozen embryos are less likely to grow into a baby than fresh ones. The second problem they face is the cost of the treatment. Sandra works as an accounts clerk and Michael in a bank. Together, they earn around £35,000. They've used up all their savings.
The cost of the treatment was about £17,000. So, really, effectively, it took a year's salary out of my pocket. Paid for by credit cards. I had the conversation with Sandra, really, saying, one more attempt on this and we're going bankrupt.
Another attempt will cost around £4,000. Sandra and Michael have come to a decision.
We thought, well, come on, you know, muster yourself together. We've still got the little ones they froze, so let's go straight in. You know, it's like having an accident, isn't it? Get straight back in the car or whatever. There you
go. Sandra and Michael take their credit cards to the limit and return to the clinic. Sandra's family is dismayed by their decision.
There is no guarantee at the end of it. And I could be risking my mum for a child that, OK, she wants it, but she has two already that want her.
Two weeks after the second attempt, Sandra's about to find out if it's worked.
The results should not take very long. The embryo transfer was done 2 weeks ago?
Yep.
Today?
Yep.
So it's either going to be definitely positive or definitely negative. So yeah. It's really a fundamental watershed day, isn't it?
We're going to be very positive this time.
No, but you could be equally disappointed.
Nervous, though.
No, you could be equally disappointed, couldn't you? We have to be realistic. You may not be scheduled to go away with a baby. We'll do our best.
Yes.
And all we can do is our best.
Yeah.
Date of birth there for me?
8845. There's no guarantees on anything. You know, you've got to be open-minded about the lot, really. So, you know, you just sort of hang on in there and just wait for that result and see what happens.
You've got result, yeah? She's pregnant. Yay!
That
unbelievable.
Hope is me. See?
What?
I'm pregnant. I told you, positive.
Fantastic. Thanks, Lucina. Very good.
Hey!
Great.
You've done it.
You're going to stay pregnant?
Yes. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Don't worry, it's fine. I'll leave you alone. You're best left alone, the two of you now, OK?
Thank you very much.
That's what we were after, wasn't it?
Yes. See? I said be positive, didn't I? Give me hope. Come on, sweetheart, you're going to be a daddy.
She had a very low chance of getting pregnant, and she's now expecting one child. I think that's magic, you're saying. That's absolutely magic. some people are being discriminated against by authority. I'm not trying to be anti-authority or anti-establishment. No, 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 no. I feel a doctor has an obligation to do his best for all his patients, whether they're really hurt that lady's age or whether they're somebody who's 21 with premature ovarian failure. That's your obligation. You have no other obligation. You have no other alternative. And if I'm seen to be controversial, then, and I'm doing my best for patients, so be it.
Sandra's family is shocked by the news.
Gobsmacked. Gobsmacked is not a strong enough word. I wouldn't dare repeat what I said when she phoned me. I wouldn't dare repeat it. You'd have too many bleeps. I couldn't believe it.
If it had happened naturally, you just accept it as part of life, don't you? But to deliberately do it, you must want the child very, very badly. You know, and no woman should be denied that, really.
Don't think nature meant women to have babies at that age. There are enough years in your life to have a baby at a safer age than to have one now. I don't understand. Did she do it for love, do you think? Is she madly in love with Michael? Enough?
It'd be so nice to actually just put that baby in his arms, you know, just say, yeah, it's yours. Because you're older, that's taboo. That's not allowed. That's disgusting, you know? What do you think you're doing at that time of life, having a child? Well, maybe, just maybe, it would be nice to have a child with Michael, who is so looking forward to it.
But just 1 week later, Sandra's bleeding. A blood test will confirm whether it's a miscarriage. Her pregnancy hormone levels must be over 10,000 to be in the clear.
Hello, Sandra.
Hi.
What was it last time?
5,205 or something like that.
5,205. Well, it's 8,334.
Up and with you as quickly as possible, yeah?
Sandra may already have lost the baby. Only further tests will tell for sure.
And you have to be philosophical about it because there's nothing you can do about
no.
it.
No.
I'm inclined, if it was me, my daughter, and that's not possible actually between our ages, push out here. If you were my daughter or my brother's wife, I would do a scan today while you're here. You mustn't expect a heartbeat today. That's a week ahead of when you might see that. And you may not even see a sac, so this may be a very crucial little test. But I think whilst we're here and we're doing blood tests because of an assessment of whether it's going up at a normal rate, it's a logical thing to do. It's the next physical dimension. It's more accurate.
Sandra will now find out whether her baby is still alive.
I think we can possibly see a fetus. I think we can see a heartbeat. Just a regular movement, look there.
That's okay.
Yeah, we can see
it. Can I have a picture?
Well, that's great. That's good news, Michael. Look. So, actually, so far, so good.
Sandra and Michael are still living 60 miles apart, and Sandra's impatient to get married. She's just turned 57.
Hi, sweetheart.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, it's lovely to see you.
Now, how old's Michael?
47. He's 10 years younger.
10 years younger. So I suppose he just wants to feel he's produced a child. Mm. It better not be just that.
No, I don't think so. No.
You're 57. Six. Oh, God. You'll be getting your pension before he's left school.
Yeah. Before we start school. So when I'm your age, you'll
yes,
be 25.
Because people are living longer.
Mm. I think it is really funny. I mean, Carol was
funny.
The best.
Funny, funny's not the word. Funny's not the word.
What's
it's
the
not
word?
Funny.
What's the word? What's the word? Maniac.
you can't say something as important as a baby. It's funny. Oh no, take care.
Don't worry. I'm going to be fine.
And tell that bloody Michael. If he doesn't look after you, I shall call him a bastard. natural. I will. He'd better look after you.
Yeah.
Both of you.
Yeah.
So kill him.
Sandra and Michael's relationship is already feeling the strain. The hormone tablets Sandra's taking to help her body cope with the pregnancy are causing terrible mood swings.
I've been a monster, an absolute monster. still am, guys, wait for it. I can change just like that. But, you know, you just say, yeah, it's 10 o'clock, it's time to take my tablet. Give me an hour, I'm going to be a shit, you know?
I'm...
Cool, calm and collected.
What Sandra calls a cold fish. I hold emotion inside completely, whereas Sandra does the reverse. Her emotions are in the outside and then kick in on the inside.
You know, if it had been me, I'd have smacked me by now with a fist, not just with a slap. You know, I'd have walked out the door.
Today is the 12-week scan. It will show whether the baby is developing normally. It's a tense time for any parent.
And this stage, at 12 weeks now, that's what you are, we'll be able to see a few bits of the baby and things that can help us in actually finding out whether there's anything wrong or not.
Looks like a monkey.
Oh, that's not kind.
This is, wow, you know, you can actually see everything that's happening inside you. I think it's amazing. And the fact that the baby's moving so much, because I was saying to you before, wasn't I, that, oh, when the baby moves, that'd be right, I know everything's OK. And you can actually see the movement, and you think, oh, why can't I feel it?
Perfectly normal, healthy baby.
Problems between Sandra and Michael are deepening. She's 3 months pregnant and they're still living separately.
See, I thought plans were, you know, we was going to get married and sell properties and buy one together. And he said, I don't know what you mean. I think you're rushing things, you know. I think, you know, we don't need to find a house now. And I said, so let's be honest about it and say, you know, nitty gritty, do you want to marry me, darling? You know, well, I've seen a different side of your character now, and I'm not sure whether I like it. And so now you're saying you not only don't want to sell your property, you don't want to marry me either. And there I am, pregnant with your child, and you're backing off like, you know, there's no tomorrow.
In the hope that a change of scenery will ease the tension, Sandra and Michael take her grandchildren on a week's holiday to the Isle of Wight.
So you can pack a packet of crisps before we get the boat? Yeah. Let's have
them tell. I'm at the moment with an awful lot of mixed feelings because her personality has altered enormously since the time that all of this started out. And I'm told by the medical experts and people like that that I have to expect that this is what's going to happen with all the tablets and everything else that she has to take in order to make this happen. And ultimately, it obviously has played havoc with her emotions. In playing havoc with her emotions, it's also played havoc with my emotions. And sometimes you can only feel, at times you can only take so much.
Yes! You're going to get it! I just can't believe what's happening. Just bang, smack out of the blue. You know, oh, he's not happy. And you think, well, why? What, you know, from my point of view, I sort of, and this doesn't sound nice either, I've done everything I possibly can to help him in his home and to have this child, which I thought is what, number one, that he wanted more than anything else in the whole wide world. You know, I mean, you could give him £1 million or whatever, and that would be nice, but he'd rather have had his own child.
In all honesty, I felt Sandra's eagerness to hold me in the relationship meant that a child would have to be needed to do that. Sandra, I felt, needed this child, perhaps more than I did, to keep us together.
Now 4 months pregnant, Sandra's facing an even bigger blow. Michael's having second thoughts about the baby.
You know, I mean, he was talking about abortion, and I'm thinking, God, you know, you spend thousands and thousands of pounds to have your child, and now you want to get rid of it. And you just think, but it's not in my makeup. It's just not me. I couldn't do that. I just, you know, completely devastated. Go on, I start snivelling. I don't understand. Stop it. I don't understand. And maybe if someone could wave a magic wand and I could understand, that would be all right, but I don't.
There are a lot of issues around our relationship at the moment that are not least in the best situation for a child to be born. The last couple of days, I've been the most difficult days of my life.
Sandra and Michael's relationship has broken down completely.
I think he had a quick reality check and realised that this was how it was going to be and that it's an awful lot to cope with.
She doesn't deserve all this. And to think he did it. He wanted to father a child, didn't he? So, God, he should treat her like... Oh... I just don't know. He should treasure her. She is a treasure. She's such a gorgeous girl. He doesn't know how lucky he is.
What are we going to do now? Don't know.
Sandra must now decide whether or not to keep the baby.
I said, really, if you're on your own and you're pregnant, at your age, you should have an abortion. That's what I would do if I was you. I wouldn't be able to do it on my own at your age. But whatever you decide, I'm behind you either way.
With pressure mounting to have an abortion, Sandra contacts the fertility clinic's counsellor.
So what do you want to do?
So, as far as I'm concerned, this is my baby, okay. You know? No, there is no way that I could have an abortion. Okay. Or...
So that's sorted out. In your own mind, can we clarify this, that you're not keeping this baby because you're hoping that he will come back to you or whatever?
No.
Because of the baby?
Yeah.
Because that doesn't happen. You're too old to think that that will happen.
No, I can't. I can't think
like
that.
If he comes back to you, he'll come anyway, but if he doesn't, he will not come because of the baby. Right?
Yeah.
I think the initial decision to have a baby probably was, let me give Michael a child that he never had, and so therefore he will stay with me. But then she didn't anticipate, I think, that some men do get scared. This is a frightening situation. This is an age at his life and her life when you're suddenly having a baby. I don't think she believed that he would actually ever leave her, you know, now that she needs him more than ever.
is my sleep for the day.
Oh. There's no point in sort of upsetting me, upsetting the baby, you know, spending hours and hours snivelling and crying and feeling sorry for myself. Get up, stand up, and get on with it, because, you know, I've got this little one. As far as I'm concerned, he's all mine. And, you know, we'll take it step by step from there.
Thirty-five years after she gave birth to Lisa, Sandra's facing the prospect of becoming a single mother.
So many things have changed. You know, I mean, apart from pregnancy, that doesn't change, you know, but... No washing machine, you know, things like that, no tumble dryer. So things are going to be, hopefully, a lot easier. This is Lisa getting christened, and my girlfriend made the shawl.
You're beautiful, like tan, bitch. Tan.
Old friends who had their children back in the 60s at the same time as Sandra have heard the news.
Yeah, well, you've
changed a bit.
Thank you very much.
We didn't have those nappies then, did we? It was all terry towel nappies then.
I've got new terry nappies.
Yeah. Oh, you're the old-fashioned one.
Well, I don't know, because when I had it, I bet you wouldn't, you know, you're not marketing me. I was doing it all by hand anyway. I didn't have a washing machine.
Well, no, I didn't. And yeah, I had a little boiler, a little...
Burko. Yeah, me too. Yeah. Yeah. I was washing everything by hand.
Yeah, I used to soak them and then put them in the boiler.
Yeah. So I thought, well, it must be a double.
You know, well, I can't believe we're two for... Well, how old are we recently? You're talking about bloody nappies. I can't believe we're simply doing this.
Now, come on, girls. Wouldn't you like to be waddling around like me?
No. I think you are really brave. I honestly do.
I don't, you know, mean to be rude, but I don't think they help people of our age.
We only just got in. Oh. And, I don't think anyone expected it to work, you see.
You are only having 56. One, are you?
Yes.
Oh, God, we're going to have a multiple bed.
She says she wants one that weighs sort of nothing with a skinny head. Yeah. She told me.
4 pounder with a head this big.
You know, just you wish.
Shucking peas, no problem. Not that I remember.
So, you went to the fertility clinic.
Yeah.
That you just...
Sandra's had worrying news. The baby could be growing too big to be born safely, a result of gestational diabetes brought on by her age.
I don't want to give birth to a 32-pound baby, so for my benefit as well as his, hopefully, I have to cut out all the sugar, and everything's got sugar in it. You wouldn't believe the things that have got sugar in it.
Unchecked, it could complicate the birth. It's yet another worry heaped on top of the concerns that any expectant mother would have.
You know, you may not need an epidural, which is a good thing. You know, depending on how you are. But we're all different, and we've all got different pain thresholds. And, you know, at the end of the day, we're the 21st century, and it's people's choice.
Is it something that we just use because it's a new thing, or does it slow the birth down?
I don't think there's any research that's actually shown that it slows the birth down.
Sandra is 30 years older than most of the other mums in her antenatal class. Most women of her age have other things on their mind.
I had my children quite young. My husband and myself, we've got a nice social life now, and
it is different. It's lovely. I love my grandson, and it's lovely to be able to just sort of pass them back there.
6 weeks to go, and the reality of becoming a single mother is beginning to sink in. Sandra's just been made redundant, so money is going to be very tight.
Actually, I thought at Christmas time this year I'd be in a different house. I would be married and settling back to sort of family life in a different way. So, should have known better. Life doesn't go that way, does it?
So we'll wait and see, you know, as to what happens next year. You know, maybe I'll win the lottery and then we'll be fine.
So he's very old and very crackly. Look at that.
Sandra now faces Christmas alone. With no Michael, no money, and no job. And a new baby in just over a month.
Christmas tree won't be baby if you're not here with me.
Michael, with just 4 weeks to go, wants to talk.
I can't believe how the time just has gone. It's really crazy.
There's so much you want to do, and there's so little time to do it in.
There's no time.
And time for us.
No, that's definitely.
You've got to try to find time for us. The only important things now are you and the baby. I wanted to sort out in my mind that we would have a nice home together and we would have the best setup for bringing a child into the world. There were an awful lot of things going on at the same time, plus where we would live. All the issues about the child's upbringing, what effect it was going to have on both of our lives. We're both equally, I suppose, wanting to get our own way, if you like, really. And what we have, actually, is we both got what we both wanted in the end, actually, which is an opportunity to be given to have a beautiful child come into our lives.
Sandra and Michael decide on a fresh start. With 1 week to go, Michael has finally agreed to get married.
To me, it's important for the baby to have Michael's name and to grow up, you know, with a mum and dad. And I just feel that we're just back on track now.
And it's where it should be. Today.
Yeah,
I'm actually very excited, very happy. Love you.
And it feels so small and helpless that my fingers fold around it like a glove. I just can't help believing when she's whispering.
Sandra and Michael haven't told the family that they're getting married. The witnesses come from an old folks' home across the road.
To witness the joining in matrimony of Michael and Sandra.
This time the girl is gonna stay.
Sandra, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
Affection and respect.
Affection and respect.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Sandra, if you'd like to place the ring on Michael's finger. Michael, I give you this ring.
Michael, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
as a symbol of my love.
Affection and respect.
Affection and respect.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
No, 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 get the water off first.
Right, and then now, very, very, now you're
easy,
ready.
Easy.
Yeah, yeah, I will.
Easy. It's going to go bad, isn't it?
Oh! Done it.
Good boy. Cheers, Mr. Sunfresh.
Too long life happens in love.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Cheers. Happy wedding day.
And you, darling.
Oh, one more.
I don't think their relationship will stand the test of time. No, I don't, not at all. There's been too many ups and downs, and they both clash and go off at tangents. It would be nice if they did, and I hope they do, but I really can't see them lasting. And I think that's just as hard on a child as anything else.
And with just 3 days to go, Sandra and Michael are still living apart. Sandra still wants to stay in her house, but it's too small for a growing child.
Tee up, guys.
So she's put all her redundancy money into building an extension for the baby.
Because it's too small. My place is too small to put a pram in. Well, if you want to take it out, it's too small to put a pram in. But if it stays indoors and doesn't move, it's fine.
Michael, still convinced he can persuade Sandra to move to his house, has decorating plans of his own.
The whole house has been decorated because this is preparation for the arrival of this wonderful baby of ours. So when all of this is finished, this possibly could be the baby's room, but at the end of the day, really, it's possible that that other room could be, whichever room Sandra and I would say is the baby's room, that will be the baby's room.
Yeah. 7 a.m. The big day has arrived.
Freezing.
Because of her age and the associated diabetes, the hospital have decided to induce the baby. Sandra's been given drugs to kickstart the labour.
Half past seven, it's now come up to half past one. Ages, ages, and nothing's happening.
8 hours later, and labour is finally underway.
Oh, it's better.
It's a waiting game, isn't it?
He's male and he's lazy. Come on, out you get.
It's critical that Sandra's diabetes is kept under control.
In labour, the uterus uses an enormous amount of glucose while it's contracting, and we monitor her blood sugars every hour and alter things accordingly, because it's extremely important, yes. We don't want, you know, uncontrolled blood sugars in any way. It's be dangerous.
Oh. No joke, you're going back into another. Sorry.
We're crossing new territory ourselves because, you know, a woman of this age is not a normal situation for us. So we're just going to treat her as we would any other woman until otherwise proved.
Oh, try and slow your breathing.
Very good.
You're doing fine.
Sandra is becoming very tired and the baby's heart rate is dropping. Although she didn't want a cesarean, Sandra might have no choice.
Because of what's happening with the baby's heart rate, I need to take you into theatres to have a cesarean. If there is any change in theatres, we may, you know, come back to plan A. But as far as we're concerned at this point, I think cesarean section is the safest option. Okay. Thank you, darling. Well done.
Do you want to print her name again?
The situation is changing rapidly.
Fine, darling. Doing fine.
It's very low, Sandra, very low indeed.
The baby is lower down than they thought, and Sandra must push on, but she's getting close to exhaustion.
She is, and hopefully...
Almost there, we are so that close now. Honestly, we are that close.
You've done all the hard work.
You don't know how close we are now. couple more crushes, that's it.
I've been waiting a long time, I should take
this. Yes. I have the woman I want, and we're going to have the baby we want. A big push. Well done, darling. Yeah, well done, darling.
That's it.
Yeah, well done.
Is that one gone?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
You're nearly there, darling.
Oh, I can't do any more.
Of course you can, darling.
I know.
You're there, darling. We're almost there. We're so close.
Sandra's struggling and the baby is in distress. Give me one. The obstetrician steps in to help with the delivery.
Just, if you want to push, just go for it now. Push.
Push.
Have a big push, big breath, big push.
Come on. Well done, darling. Come on.
Well done. There's the cord around the baby's neck, which probably caused all...
Here it comes.
Push, give it...
Well done! Well done. Oh, look at him. He's an angel, darling. He's an angel. I love you.
Baby Joshua is born at 12:07 and weighs 7 lbs 8 oz.
Words cannot describe how happy I am at the moment and how proud I am of Sandra.
Ready to
see,
meet this little man?
Sandra has him first. Here we go, our little boy, our little joy.
Hey, baby. You're really real then, aren't you?
Yeah, too righty is real. Too righty is.
And I think it's hard work. It must have been even worse for you, baby.
You've made it, and you've made it, darling.
What do you think? What do you think?
4 days later, Sandra, Michael and baby Joshua go home to Sandra's house.
You want to poke your tongue out?
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, Daddy. Hello, Mummy. Say hello, Mummy. That's that face. I know that face. That face feeds me.
It doesn't matter what people say. It's your life. It's your baby's life. It doesn't matter whether you're 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. It doesn't make any difference. As long as you've got a stable, loving environment where you're absolutely sure that Mum and Dad love you to bits, you know, there's nothing else you've got to worry about. And he's beautiful. And he's worth it. And he's absolutely perfect. Because that's what you are, isn't it?
I think she's going to thoroughly enjoy the whole thing. I think she's going to be absolutely wonderful with it. It's really going to be great.
And we're all the family are going to enjoy this child.
Mum's ecstatically happy and I'm pleased for her, but I find it really hard thinking of Joshua as a brother. Even now he's born, I find it extremely hard. Whether or not I ever will, I don't know, but I still haven't settled down to it yet.
It's fantastic.
It's like having a reason, isn't it, to survive. I don't know. It's just like the whole reason that you're sort of on the earth, really.
Michael and Sandra still have 3 frozen embryos stored at the clinic. They are now considering using them to have another baby.